As you can see, spin the car around so you can actually see it. It looks very convincing. Three simple washes. It only takes a couple minutes to actually get through each car. Slap some dull coat on it and it's ready for your layout. Here's the other car that we did. Just rotate it around so you can get a look at it. I said, slap some dull coat on it. With the three steps on those washes, you'll end up with a very nice looking car. Even after the first step, it's good for the layout. The other rock car, as you can see as it turns, you can see the streaks on the side. The tech thing that I do like on this car that I did not do is the fact that if you look at the paint, this is from Atlas, that they've kind of done an overbrush on it like it was actually done that way. I kind of like that. I've been using that on my own models. You look at the streaks on the side of that. Three washes. Hit it with dull coat, ready to go. Granted, the trucks aren't done yet. We'll do that in a different segment. Then this car still needs to be resprayed with some dull coat to even everything out, get rid of that washed out look. But I'll just put it up in here for now because I really don't want to dull coat it until I finish the airbrushing on it. We'll cover that in another segment. Just a quick airbrush and the final car. We'll be changing trucks on it so it has microtrain couplers on it eventually. Hitting with the dull coat so it evens out the flat look on it. Hitting it with a little bit of other little spray paints. With the airbrush, do the bottom. This will conclude our segment on the three-part weathering wash. Real simple, real easy to do. Looks good. Even after the first wash is applied, you can put them on the layout and be happy with them. Next segment, we'll discuss airbrushing more detail onto the cars.